September 28th, the Catholic Church honors Saint Wenceslaus, a Central European ruler who died at the hands of his brother while seeking to strengthen the Catholic faith in his native Bohemia. During his 2009 visit to Czech Republic, Pope Benedict XVI called the country's patron saint a martyr for Christ who had the courage to prefer the kingdom of heaven to the enticement of the world power. Saint Wenceslaus was born around the year 903. His father, Duke Brastislav, was a Catholic, but his mother, Princess Dragomir, practiced the native pagan religion. She would later arrange the murders of both Wenceslaus and his grandmother, Ludmila. During his youth, Wenceslaus received a strong religious education from Ludmila, in addition to the good example of his father. He maintained a virtuous manner of living while attending college near Prague, making significant progress both academically and spiritually. But with the death of his father, the devout young nobleman faced a spiritual and political crisis. His mother, Dragomir, who had never accepted the Catholic faith, turned against it entirely. She sees her husband's death as a chance to destroy the religion his parents had received from Saint Cyril and Methodius, through methods that included purging Catholics from public office, closing churches, and preventing all teaching of the faith. Dragomir's Catholic mother-in-law, Ludmila, urged Wenceslaus to seize power from his mother and defend the faith. His attempt to do so resulted in the division of the country into two halves, one ruled by Wenceslaus, advised by Ludmila, and the other ruled by Wenceslaus' younger brother, Boleslaus, who had absorbed his mother's hatred for the church. Wenceslaus, who would have preferred to become a monk and not a duke, fortified himself in this struggle through fervent prayer, extreme asceticism, charitable service, and a vow of chastity. Meanwhile, his mother carried out a plot to kill Ludmila, having her strangled in her private chapel. Saint Ludmila's liturgical feast day is September 16. The Bohemian Duke also faced the threat of invasion from abroad. When Prince Radislaus of Kurima demanded that Bohemia submit to his rule, when Wenceslaus sought to avoid a war by challenging him in single combat, two angels are said to have appeared, deflecting the javelin thrown at Wenceslaus and immediately inspired Radislaus to drop to his knees in surrender. During his period of rule, Wenceslaus received the relics of several saints from the Holy Roman Emperor Otto I, who also conferred on him the title of King Wenceslaus. But some noblemen of his own country resented the sainty king's strict morals and allied themselves with Dragomir and Boleslaus. Wenceslaus' brother sought to appear as a peacemaker, inviting the king to his realm for a celebration. When Wenceslaus was praying in a chapel during the visit, Boleslaus' henchmen attacked and wounded him. Boleslaus himself delivered the final blow by running him through with a lance. Saint Wenceslaus died on September 28, 935. Emperor Otto responded to Saint Wenceslaus' death by invading Bohemia and making war against Boleslaus for several years. He succeeded in conquering the region and forced Boleslaus to reverse the anti-Catholic measures. There is no evidence that Dragomir, who died soon after the murder of Saint Wenceslaus, ever repented of killing her family members. Boleslaus, however, came to regret his sin when he learned of the miracles that were taking place at his brother's tomb. He moved Saint Wenceslaus' body to a cathedral for veneration by the faithful. Today, 1,083 years after the martyrdom of Saint Wenceslaus, we continue celebrating him as our parish patron. We have been celebrating Saint Wenceslaus in our parish, consecrated to him for over 106 years. We continue celebrating our faith with gratitude to the founders of this community and welcoming new generations. We take this opportunity to learn more, celebrate our faith together, and grow together in sanctity.